Hi there, I'm Dr. Francesca Zampollo, and as you know, I talk about food design. Today, I want to talk to you about a beer made with bread, but not just that. We are at theguardian.com, and we want to talk about this beer here, conveniently called Toast, and you will see in a moment why. It is a tasty solution to the shocking daily waste of bread, with more than 24 million slices thrown away in Britain every day, by customers alone. So we're not talking about food businesses also. Three new beers will soon be available at the supermarket Marks & Spencer, made from surplus bread from its sandwich factory that would otherwise be discarded or turned into animal feed. Suffolk Brewery Adnams is using the crusted ends of sliced sandwich loaves frozen by Marks & Spencer suppliers and then sent to the brewery headquarters to create new beers, which are already on sale in some Marks & Spencer stores and will soon be available to others online. And if you are not familiar with this type of bread, because maybe you are in a side of the world where you don't see this type of sandwiches very often, we're talking about all the sliced bread from which the crust is cut. Because for some reason people prefer to have their sandwiches without crust. I guess it's visually more appealing without thinking about all the waste that they create, but thankfully there are organizations that are creating alternatives for this waste. Making beer out of bread isn't new. Its history stretches back to 4,000 years to a time when brewers and bakers worked together. The difference is that the new beers use bread that would otherwise go to waste. And this is what I think is interesting about this art, about this new product, and what I think is worth mentioning again and being inspired by it again. So it's not just a new beer made from bread, beautiful, but I think that what is more interesting for us interested in food designers to put our attention on is that this is an example of food system design, because the waste from one business becomes the raw material, the resources for another business. And this is what I like about it, that two businesses have been linked. The waste from one has been taken and used as a resource, as a raw material in another business. Whenever you start a new business and start sourcing materials, this type of example shows us that we should start looking for raw materials from somebody else's waste instead of from a producer. Food for thought. Thank you for watching this video. Have a lovely day and happy food design.